Hello, I'm Vishnu. I bought this computer for under 5000 rupees, made by Intel. This is currently the cheapest computer that can run Windows 11. And it also comes with the operating system preloaded. This computer is called Intel Next Unit of Computing, or NUC in short. It comes with 4GB of RAM, which can be expanded to 32GB. It also has 64GB of storage space and can be expanded to 2TB using an additional SSD. It can run standard applications fine and will also do a little bit of gaming. With a few optimizations, you can get the best out of this computer. You can also use some of these techniques to speed up the machine that you are currently using. Please note that this is not a sponsored review. I bought this computer with the prize money that I received along with a medal for academic excellence in general science. Prices of computers have been on the higher side for the past 3 years. They are cooling down now. If you are looking for a computer that gets the basic tasks done, this Intel NUC Mini PC is a perfect solution. It comes with a 3-year warranty, consumes as little as 20 watts, and you can keep it powered on all the time. It has two HDMI ports that support dual 4K displays. You can also make it a media center by connecting it to a television, or let it quietly do its job as a file server or a streaming device. This mini PC came in a well-packed cube-shaped box. Inside it, there's a quick start guide, a VESA mount to attach the PC to the back of a monitor, the necessary screws and a 65W power adapter with a barrel jack pin. This Intel NUC is actively cooled with a laptop fan inside it. The warm air is blown out of these heat vents. These are the two HDMI 2.0 ports that support dual 4K 60 displays. This is the gigabit Ethernet port, and these are a couple of USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports that can do 5 Gbps each. The barrel jack of the power adapter goes in here, and just like laptop chargers, it works on standard 19V DC power. This is not an optical out port, it is just a rubber cover. The sides have evenly spread out vents for air intake. The front has a couple of USB 3.2 ports, the yellow one being a power delivery port, meaning it will stay powered on even when the computer is off. It is useful to charge PC accessories and mobile phones as well. There's a power switch with a blue LED indicator. The disk activity indicator can be configured to glow either orange or blue. These again are dummy holes, not microphones. On the other side, there's a full-sized SD card reader and a Kensington lock to prevent the mini PC from theft. The genuine Windows hologram label is on the bottom of the case. Overall, this mini PC is just 4 inches on the longer sides. With a total volume of a little over half a liter, it will comfortably fit into any backpack. There are 4 screws at the bottom, and the rubber caps around them help with tool-less removal. On the inside, there are 2 RAM slots, one of which is already filled with 4GB of DDR4 memory. The AC series Wi-Fi chip is soldered down to the motherboard, and these wires serve as the antennas. You can upgrade the storage using a SATA SSD. The initial setup is quite simple. Connect the mini PC to a HDMI monitor or a television and power it on. This mini PC does alright with regular tasks such as browsing. It can also run applications like MS Office comfortably. I have connected 2 HDMI monitors and extended the displays. It's an excellent choice for productivity. YouTube video performance is decent too. Although the PC supports dual 4K displays, the integrated graphics has just enough power to drive 2K video without any frame drops. If you plan to use this PC as a media center in conjunction with your television, it will work fine at 2K resolution. On the gaming front, the NUC plays the low-end games like Roblox alright. The games that are more graphics intensive will struggle to play, and this mini PC just does not have the horsepower to drive high-end games. Even during peak usage, the processor did not exceed 70 degrees centigrade. The fan noise is not audible at all. The processor of this NUC is Intel Celeron J4025, which is more aligned towards saving power. But with a few upgrades and optimizations, you can get better performance from this NUC. Checking the system monitor, the memory usage is around 2.8 GB for Windows 11. This is prior to opening any applications, so there is only 1 GB of RAM available for applications. Adding more RAM can help run many applications simultaneously. The process is quite simple. Buy a stick of DDR4 RAM, insert it into the slot and push it down to lock it in place. While the specifications of the processor say that it supports a maximum of 8 GB RAM, I tried two 16 GB RAM sticks for a total of 32 GB and it worked fine. 2400 and 2666 MHz RAM were compatible, but 3200 MHz RAM was not, so keep that in mind. Ideally, I think an additional 8 GB is enough. It will bring the total RAM to 12 GB, which is sufficient for this processor. The links to the compatible RAM are in the description of this video. Now that you have plenty of RAM, you can turn off the memory compression. This will remove the compression overhead on the processor and make more of it available for applications. Open Windows PowerShell as administrator and give a command. You can do this on any computer that has lots of RAM and speed it up. If you do not wish to upgrade but still want a faster computer, you got to install Linux on it. This mini PC works at its absolute best with Linux. Even at its stock configuration, there is plenty of headroom for applications in Linux. And there are tons of games too. Except for the SD card reader, everything else works fine with Linux. You can as well dual boot the PC. This will leave the Windows partition as it is, and you can switch between Windows and Linux when needed. Just push a SATA SSD into the drive bay provided inside the NUC and install Linux to it. If you wish to stick to Windows only, I will strongly recommend adding more RAM and using an additional SSD for your data. With only 28 GB left after installing Windows 11, there is just not enough space for data. Although the built-in eMMC has good read speeds, the lack of capacity is a concern. You can either use the SSD as an extended storage or transfer your Windows installation to the SSD. Let me know if you want me to do a video explaining the process. To clean install Windows to the new SSD, just use the digital license of Windows 11 Home on the NUC. You can retrieve the product key using a command, and I have provided the instructions in the description of this video. This mini PC is clearly a budget product, and like any other product, it has some shortcomings. The NUC does not have an audio out. Although it supports 7.1 channel audio, that is through HDMI only. Fortunately, there is Bluetooth 5.0 built-in, which can connect Bluetooth headsets and speakers. Being digital, the audio quality is excellent. There is no M.2 NVMe slot on the motherboard. Although the NUC supports SATA SSDs, M.2 NVMe would have helped, since it is at least 6 times faster. This mini PC did not come with a power cord. I had to buy it separately and it costed me 200 rupees. There's a lot of metal inside the NUC. The metal around the borders assists with the structural rigidity. Also, the Kensington lock fixes to this strong metal frame. But what about this metal cage for the SSD? I think it is over-engineered to an extent. It adds unnecessary weight to the product and taxes the portability. It also shields the Wi-Fi to some degree and reduces its range. The core USP of this product is its price point. The Intel NUC is usually listed for 7990 on online stores. Occasionally, it goes down to 5990. By using card offers, you get an additional discount of another 1000 rupees. That will bring the final purchase price to 4990. If you have any questions, you can put them in the comments below. I hope you found the review useful. Thanks for your time and have a great day. This is Arjun and Vishnu signing off.